and dwelleth amongst us. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
So you hear Christmas, and one of the first things that comes to mind is the famous Santa Claus, or maybe Christmas trees and ornaments, snow. Well, depending on what part of the world you're from, it's the baby Jesus, it's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, gifts that really make Christmas what it is in our modern world. So Christmas over the years has really transformed into a tradition that is embraced by many American families and cultures around the globe. It's one of the most sacred yet secular holidays celebrated in the world. But before there is Christmas, there is Saturnalia, and that was a pagan holiday celebrated at the winter solstice to observe the return of the sun.
Saturnalia started out as a Roman holiday celebrated on the December date of 17th to commemorate the Greek mythological god of Saturn by name Cronos. Now, years later, as the celebration grew to become one of the most popular festivals in Rome, it was then extended from just a one-day celebration to a seven-day celebration. The duration of Saturnalia was a period of lawlessness. There was basically a complete absence of order in every area of the civilian and non-civilian population. You know, people pretty much had the freedom to indulge in any desired act, you know, from heavy drinking to gambling to offering of animals and human sacrifices. All were acceptable. So basically what it started out on the Julian calendar as one of the greatest and perhaps the wildest festivity in the history of the Roman culture has now, on the Gregorian calendar, become the epitome festive season of giving and receiving of gifts in cultures and nations around the globe. It's what we now call Christmas.
This Christian reimagining of the Saturnalia holiday took place in the 4th century with the intent of replacing the worship of the sun god with worship of the Son of God. Christmas celebrates the birth of Jesus. God himself wrapped in flesh come to live among us. And 33 years later, for the redemption of us all, he'll be offered up as a sacrifice. One thing that struck me as I was reading about Saturnalia was that animals and humans were offered up to Cronus as a sacrifice. So this December holiday went from death and human sacrifice to Christ replacing that with himself as a sacrificial gift for us. What a more perfect gift than one holy and without blemish. On the night that Jesus was born, a mysterious, luminous star appeared in the sky to three wise men. And without understanding, they turned to their scrolls. And what did those scrolls reveal?
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor,
the Mighty God,
the Everlasting Father,
the Prince of Peace.
And therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and his name will be called Emmanuel, God with us.
This association of gifts with Christmas in modern society is commonly personified as Santa Claus. He grew from Catholics' stories of St. Nicholas of Myra. He was born in Turkey in the 300s, and he later became associated with giving of gifts to children. His image was later used to replace the Roman god of Saturn because he represented the opposite character of him. He was known to give gifts to children rather than taking them in as sacrifices. The typical contemporary depiction of Santa Claus descending the chimney and wearing red actually came from the 1900s Coca-Cola advertisement, and of course Clement Moore's 1823 poem, which begins, "'Twas the night before Christmas."
However, even more than Santa, perhaps the most recognized symbol of the holiday is the Christmas tree. Originating in pre-Christian Germany, the Tannenbaum is a decorated evergreen which has since been given Christian meaning. Pope John Paul himself said that the Christmas tree was an ancient custom that exalts the value of life. And because the evergreen tree remains unchanged throughout even the harshest of winters, it's also been seen as a symbol for Jesus. Martin Luther, a Christian reformer, is said to have decorated evergreen trees. And this tradition later spread to Britain in the 1800s due to an international political marriage of royal families. The rest of the nation soon followed along.
So the winter solstice was long celebrated on and around December 25th, but it was the Roman Emperor Constantine who chose to celebrate Christ's birth as a civil holiday, and then it was Pope Julius I who chose December 25th as the Mass of Christ, or Christmas, as the day to recognize Jesus' birth. So this secular and religious holiday has really shifted in its popularity over the years. In fact, due to the non-religious nature of how it was being observed, Puritans of Boston actually outlawed celebrating Christmas in 1659. Families were fined 5 shillings if they were caught celebrating. Now, this ban was revoked 20 years later in the 1680s, and then 200 years later in 1870, Congress declared December 25th, Christmas, a federal holiday. So Charles Dickens' novel, A Christmas Carol, came out in 1843, and it actually had an immense cultural impact. The whole story of Ebenezer Scrooge being visited by the spirits of Christmas really reinvigorated interest in the day, but with a more secular angle than had been there previously. So the day became more a time of generosity, family, eating, and gifts. And it eventually developed into a very commercialized season. I mean, so much so that the last 2 months of the year, arts and entertainment with a Christmas theme really dominate the social landscape.
So what we have here is a day and a season of celebrating darkness becoming a season of celebrating light. The winter solstice became the new representation of Christ's birth. You know, so Jesus did not destroy the fun. He was rather introduced into the cultures and nations around the globe. You know, he was infused into what previously was. And that's exactly what Christians say that Christ does. You know, when people welcome him into their lives, the people become new creations with new life. You know, we are still the same people, but as the scripture says, "Behold, the old is gone, and all things have become new."
I don't know. I'd say that's a reason to celebrate on any day.
So with that being said, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Feliz Navidad.